My project is about childhood fantasy, or actually how children see the world, and there seems to be no distinction in their minds between reality and fantasy. And I really admire that they have that, and I wish everyone could keep that when we're still adults, but I'm afraid that we lose it once we grow older. So in my project, I try to find out if it's actually possible to keep that childlike way of seeing the world. And I revisited an old fantasy of mine about a fantasy world called Ondonopo, which is beneath the ice of the North Pole. And it's a story me and my father came up with, and it grew from this bedtime story that he once told me to a very big universe in my mind. And now I'm exploring that universe again and taking pictures of it. Well, since this world of my imagination on the Nopo is beneath the ice of the North Pole, I looked a lot for ice, since you have that in Iceland. So I went to glaciers, and I also went to a lot of waterfalls. There has been already sort of a story in my mind about how this world could look like, or what the people of this world would do. So I try to look for elements that came from my story in the real world. So for instance, the people from Ondonopo, they need to eat, of course, they need food. And sometimes there is an ice bear that falls through the ice of the North Pole and then dies. And then they make use of it by eating its flesh and making clothes out of its fur. So I needed to photograph an ice bear. So I just went to look for an ice bear and photographed that. Because the final image, the ice bear looks quite cuddly. Like he could be a toy for a kid to play with. Well, at the same time, it's of course a dangerous animal, but I like this, this duality of it, that it's dangerous, but a kid sees a nice big bear that you can cuddle. I hope that, if for instance, an adult sees this, who has already kind of lost their childlike fantasy, I hope that this project can spark their fantasy again, so that in the end, after they've seen this, they will look at the world in a more open way, in a more childlike way. And of course, you don't have to act like a child, but I think that if everyone keeps this little bit of wonder into their daily routine, you notice a lot more interesting stuff about the world, and you can solve problems in better ways, and I feel like it's just a more positive way to approach the world.